As you may have already known, with the advent of the administration of President Duterte, there also came a changing of the guard at the government agency that coordinates public services in the Metro, the MMDA, or the Metro Manila Development Authority. The acting chairman, general manager, Thomas Orbos, is here with us this week to give us an idea of what to expect from the MMDA with him now at the helm. Good afternoon, Mr. Orbos, and welcome to Motoring Today.
Good afternoon, Butch, and to all the viewers of Motoring Today.
For the benefit of our Metro citizens and denizens who are indeed curious and interested to find out the kind of leadership they can now expect from the new administration of the MMDA, would you kindly give us an idea of your background as a public servant before you assumed your present position as MMDA officer in charge?
Well, I've been in and out of the public sector, so I work both in the public and private sector. I used to be in Malacanang for 2 years in the old administration as assistant secretary to the executive secretary then. And I was also for 6 months the assistant general manager here in MMDA.
Thank you for that, Mr. Orbos. Now please tell us, needless to say, solving the Metro's traffic problem is paramount among the array of almost endless tasks that your agency is mandated to take care of. Where is the MMDA now with regard to solving this perennial problem, which many have accepted as a disgusting way of life?
I think you've heard of the interagency efforts, which is called the Interagency Council on Traffic, including the agencies of DOTR, LTFRB, LTO, HPG, and MMDA. With this conglomeration of agencies, I believe that we can immediately resolve at least some parts of the problems on traffic, given the fact that some of the powers that are not with MMDA that is needed for traffic is with the other agencies. As part of the IACT, MMDA is given the role of giving the human, the manpower support, technical support, and logistical support for the overall traffic management in Metro Manila.
Now tell us, how do you regard the observation that's coming from numerous quarters that one of the major causes of traffic in the Metro is the overabundance of buses that ply its streets, many of which are illegal or colorums?
Well, I agree that there are colorum and out-of-line buses, but more than that, I think it's the rationalization of the routes of these buses in areas probably that we may need them or we may not need them. And that's the reason why the IACT, and to say also the emergence of the emergency powers will come into play, because we will then be rationalizing such routes according to the need of the city, according to the need of Metro Manila.
Mr. Orbos, do you support the move to phase out public utility vehicles that are 15 years or older, whether buses or jeepneys?
I fully support that action, given the fact that we have right now thousands of vehicles that are 15 years and older that are not just contributing to traffic but as well as to the pollution, no? Not to mention the safety of our passengers. So definitely I am for that move.
Tell us, Mr. Chairman, how do you perceive the suggestion, as a matter of fact, now a proposed legislation, to require proof of a garage before a vehicle is allowed to register, the no garage, no car policy?
100%. I fully agree with that 100%. But just to say this, it does not have to be your garage in your own house. It can be a communal garage that is set forth by the barangay or the village. So it doesn't have to be your private garage, but at least there is a space for your vehicle.
Sir, are you still seriously pushing for the revival of the drug test for everyone applying for a driver's license, despite the move to make these licenses be valid for 5 years, or despite the professional opinion of many doctors that such test is so easy to go around with?
I think more important than that is having the drug tests mandatory for all public utility vehicle drivers. More important for me because they are the ones that take care of our riding public. No? It's in their hands. So more, even before that is discussed, I think what should immediately be done is to have them tested for use of drugs.
Thank you very much for giving us a large portion of your time, Mr. Orbos, despite your very hectic schedule. Before we end, any message to our viewers?
We just have to work it out together. The problem of traffic is not just the problem of the government. It is both the problem of government and the private sector. In the same manner, the solution of traffic is both given or should be done by both the private sector and the government. So hand in hand, we will solve this problem. Thank you.
Thank you once again, Mr. Orbos.
Thank you, Butch, and happy motoring.
That was MMDA, OIC, and General Manager Thomas Orbos, our distinguished guest today on Motoring Today's Motoring Forum.